Some people at your agency require liquid consistency modifications. It's critical that you follow these orders. Typically, there are three main liquid consistencies. We'll go over each one and show you how to make it.
The trick is proper measuring. If you follow the directions exactly, it will come out just right. Kind of like baking. Size matters.
Here are the main tools that you'll need for a thickened liquid. Measuring cups, measuring spoons, a knife, a spoon, and the thickening agent.
We're going to demonstrate to you now how to make thickening liquids using this product. Please follow the directions carefully of any product that you may choose.
First, read the directions before starting and gather what you'll need. This product starts with 4 fluid ounces. That means you should be using a liquid measuring cup to pour the right amount of liquid. Make sure to see the liquid at eye level to ensure the exact amount.
Then, read the directions to determine how much thickener should be added to your liquid. A big T, or TBSP, stands for tablespoon. A small T, or TSP, stands for teaspoon. A very common mistake is to use the wrong spoon.
So when measuring, level off the product with the back of a knife. Then what you're going to want to do is slowly add the product into the liquid while stirring briskly. Stir for about 15 seconds and then let stand for 1 to 5 minutes. It will then reach the desired consistency.
These directions work for all liquid consistencies. The difference is how much thickener you add to the liquid.
Nectar should be the consistency of room temperature maple syrup and fall off the spoon like this.
Honey should be the consistency of room temperature honey.
And pudding should be like pudding. You can stand a spoon in it, and it must be spooned into someone's mouth. So refer to any special guidelines and always check the diet orders for each individual before preparing the modified foods and liquids to ensure accuracy. A safe and happy dining environment is the goal.
Bon appetit!